Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. In this video, we will be showing many close-up videos of the sun. These images were taken using special equipment by highly trained people. But we suggest that you never look at the sun, since doing so could make you blind. It is especially dangerous to look at the sun using a telescope. If you have not already done so, we suggest that you view parts 1 and 2 in this astronomy miniseries before watching this video. There is an old saying that the stars only come out at night. Why don't we see stars in the day? Although they are easier to see at night, stars are always in the sky. There are two reasons why we don't see them in the day. The first reason is that when the sun's light hits the air in our atmosphere, that light scatters such that the air turns blue and blocks our view of stars. At night, there is no sunlight, so the air is not blue. The second reason that we don't see stars during the day is due to how our eyes and cameras work. When we look at this phone's screen inside, then we can see all the details on it. But when we move the phone near the window, then we cannot see anything on its screen. But if we bring the phone back inside, then we can see the screen's details again. The screen is the same brightness all the time, but it's our eyes and cameras that make it look dark outside. When it's very bright, our pupils get so small that we then cannot see faint things like a dim phone screen or distant stars. Once in a while, sunlight is blocked during the day if the moon's orbit passes exactly between the sun and the earth, such that the moon casts a shadow on the earth. This is called a solar eclipse, and only lasts for about 5 minutes until the earth has rotated and the moon has orbited to a different position. If you look very carefully at this solar eclipse, you can see stars in the sky during the daytime because the sunlight is blocked by the moon, so the sunlight will not turn the air blue. This is the image from the solar eclipse of 1919 that made Albert Einstein famous because it proved one of his theories. If you've learned to recognize a few star constellations, such as Orion, then you may have noticed that they are only visible for some months of the year. Why can we only see stars at some times of the year? To answer the question about why the night sky changes every night, we'll combine two facts. The first fact is that we can only see stars at night. That means when we are looking at the stars, it is only at night, which is the direction away from the sun. The second fact is that the Earth orbits the sun, and it takes a year to do that. In January, the Earth is on this side of the sun, and the night sky is located in this direction, so it looks like this. 6 months later, the Earth has orbited to the other side of the sun. So the night sky is located in the opposite direction and looks like this. Although astrology uses some constellation names, astrology is not part of astronomy or any branch of science. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Many of us are surprised to hear that our sun is a star, just like all the other stars that we see in the night sky. Our sun is an average-sized star and has an average amount of brightness. So then, why is it so much warmer, brighter, and bigger to us than the other stars? The reason is because the sun is so much closer to us than any other star. Just as taillights on cars that are closer to us seem bigger and brighter than those that are farther away, a star that is closer to us seems bigger and brighter than those that are far away. This video is of the sun, but using a special filter that changes the sun's color. We can see that the sun is rotating on its axis, which means it's spinning. There are areas that seem to be very active and others that are less active. Every 11 years, the sun goes through a cycle of high, then low activity. Astronomers estimate the sun is 5 billion years old and will continue like this for another 5 billion years. With this filter, we can see dark areas on the sun's surface which are called sunspots and are a little cooler than other areas. Sunspots usually come and go and may last weeks, and appear to be more common about every 11 years. The sun is so huge that one small sunspot is bigger than the entire Earth. The sun's mass is more than 330,000 times the Earth's mass and much bigger than anything in the solar system. Once the sunspots fade, that area where they were may become extremely hot and lead to huge explosions. Depending on its shape, these explosions are called solar prominences or coronal loops. The word corona means the sun's atmosphere. These explosions may be associated with very hot and bright areas in the corona, which are called solar flares. When particles from the sun shoot off into space, that's called a coronal mass ejection. These particles make up the solar wind and solar weather, which is a stream of particles from the sun. The Earth has a magnetic field that you probably detected with a compass. That magnetic field is like a shield and deflects the particles in the solar wind away from the Earth, and some to the poles where they interact with our atmosphere to make bright lights called auroras, which we commonly call northern lights. Sometimes, the solar wind causes problems with radio reception. Here's a summary of this section. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. Our final topic is how stars like our sun make heat and light. When we burn something, we get heat and light through a process called a chemical reaction. Using a chemical reaction, these logs get to about 500 degrees Celsius and are enough to warm up 5 campers for an evening. But the sun makes heat and light through a process called nuclear fusion, which reaches 15 million degrees Celsius. If we could use nuclear fusion on these logs, we would be able to make 3 million times as much heat and light compared to if we burned them in a campfire. For a review of what a chemical reaction is, please see our introductory video on conservation of mass. All matter is made of tiny particles called atoms. For example, with these models, the red balls represent oxygen atoms, the purple balls are calcium atoms, and the white balls are hydrogen atoms. During a chemical reaction, we rearrange how the atoms are grouped. In this reaction, when we put an over-the-counter antacid tablet in vinegar, we made different groups of atoms, including molecules of water and carbon dioxide. But the total number of each atom type is the same at the start and at the end of the chemical reaction. We cannot make or change individual atoms in a chemical reaction. In contrast, nuclear reactions do make or change individual atoms. In the sun, 2 hydrogen atoms fuse to make 1 helium atom. So the helium in our party balloons was made inside a star long ago. Since nuclear fusion produces much more energy than chemical reactions and makes no pollution, scientists have been trying to find a way to use nuclear fusion on Earth in a safe way. One method is to use a container called a tokamak, like this cutaway view shows. There is a huge experimental tokamak being built in France called ITER that is a combined effort of many countries. It is scheduled to start in 2035. Another method is to use lasers, as is being done by the National Ignition Center. In December 2022, this center made a major research advance using lasers, though there is still a lot of research to do. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.